We are on Shekalim Perek Dalid, Mishnah Aleph, first Mishnah in the fourth chapter of Masechet Shekalim. So once we collected the money, now we have to know what to do with it. Says the Mishnah, Hatruma Mayu Osimba, great question. What would they do with the money that people had donated? First of all, Lochimba Timidim, Korbatami, the daily korbanot that they would offer, Umusafim, the special korbanot on special days like Shabbat, Yom Tov, Rosh Chodesh, Binisrayim, and their libations. Okay, the Nisrayim means the wine offerings that were offered with them. Ha'omer, the Korban Ha'omer that was offered on Pesach, the second day of Pesach. Ushte Ha'lechem, that was on Shavuot. Let's make sure that was okay. The Ushte Ha'lechem was brought on Shavuot, right? The Lechem Ha'panim, the showbread that were brought by the Kohanim, these huge breads that were put on the Shulchan every Shabbat. V'chol Korbanot Tzibur, and any other public Korbanot, including the Kahati says, including the Ketoret. The Bartinur says that too. Okay, in addition, very interesting, Shomrei Sfichim B'Shvi, they would pay for the Shomrim, the guards of Sfichim. Sfichim are, let's look at Bar Tunura, Tvua Ha'ola Me'eleha, Imashen Hashem B'Katzir, it was Tvua, grain that would grow on its own. The reason you had to do this was, during Shvi'it, how would you bring the Omer, the Korban Ha'omer? If you didn't have a harvest, then how would you bring new produce? So therefore, Notnim Schar L'Shomrim, you give money to the Shomrim, to the guards, Shelo yilkatu mani b'shvi'it, so that the poor people won't take this grain on the shvi'it. So therefore, that they'll have grain to bring these korbanot. Umivi'im mehem omer b'pesach, and they would bring from this grain that grew on its own the korban omer, the barley offering on Pesach. Ushte halechem ba'atzeret, and these two breads. She'inam ba'im ela mina chadash mina aretz, they have to be brought from this year's crop, and there is no crop this year, so they had to make sure that the crop grew. And the way they would make sure that nobody took the grain was by putting shomrim there. Okay, even odim scharam, you pay their money, you pay the salary of the shomrim, mina truma. From this truma, why? The tzorach korban ke korban dam, it was a need of the korban. The need for the korban could be paid from the till, from the account of the korbanot. So there's therefore shomrei svichim, the guards of these svichim. Svichim are we normally nowadays, we use it to refer to fruits that grow on their own, but here it refers to produce. Grains that grow on their own, on Shvi'it, on the Shemitah year, notlim scharam mitrumat halishka, you pay their salary from this trumat halishka, from this money that was designated from these collection boxes. Rabbi Yossi says, no, afarotzeh, if somebody wants to volunteer, midnadev shomer chinam, he can watch it on his own also. So if I watch it on my own, I can also say, here, I watched this grain, no, I didn't want anybody to take it for the korban. Amrulo, so they said to him, Afata Omer, wouldn't you agree, She'inam ba'im ela mishel tzibor, that the money, that the korbanot have to come from community korbanot. So the Kahati explains that Rabbi Yossi disagreed and said, no, a private person can give money, as long as he gives it freely, it can also come from the tzibor. If I give it to the community, that can be called the korban tzibor as well, just like any money that they give. Okay, and the answer is, that we pass it like the chachamim, not that a person can't give his money, but they wanted this shomer. They wanted the Shomer Svichim, they wanted them to guard because they were afraid of Baalei Zroa. They were afraid of powerful people that would, if a person was a private individual, we relied on private individuals, then powerful people could kick them off the land. But if it's a community, if it was a Shomer from the Beit HaMikdash, everybody would leave him alone. That way they ensured that they had the produce needed to offer the korbanot. We'll stop here and dedicate our learning to memory of my father, Rav Simcha Meir Yitzchak Kalman, and Tzipora Feiga Matilda Bat Nachum Eli Melech. Have a great day.